How fast was the process from when you started with Corman to release, and what was your budget like?
The budget on this film was $600,000 at the time. It was a 16-day shoot, and it was like a couple of months in post because of all the rotoscoping. And it was made for Vestron, because the Vestron had called Julie Corman and said, "We want to film about a killer in a mall." And Julie was in my office. She said, "Hey, Wynorski, you got any ideas about a killer in a mall?" And I wrote up this treatment and handed it to her. She faxed it to Vestron, and they bought it. And I was writing a script the following day. And that's how it works with Rock, you know. When I first started with him, he walked into my office and said, "You know, I think we missed the boat with these Conan pictures. We don't have one." This was a Monday. He said, "Why don't you take the rest of the week off and write a script, bring it in on Saturday." You know, when Roger Corman asked you to write a script in a week, you do. And it was like 74 pages. It was the best I could do in 4 or 5 days. They made it. It's called Sorceress. Maybe they'll show it here one night. I think they showed it in Texas.
Directed by Jack Hill?
Directed by Jack Hill. It was the last film he did for Roger.
This guy
knows everything. Anyway, Jack did a great job.
Somebody lost their wallet in the last show.
Check under your seat.
That was mine.
Sorry, don't mean to press.
It's got $40, right?
Black wallet.
It's gone. It's proud.
Be honest.
Be not trusting.
Bob rules.
What
did you do for Corman before you wrote this?
The first thing I wrote for Corman was a movie called Forbidden World, which was kind of an alien ripoff. It's what he wanted. And then I followed that with Sorceress, and then I followed that with a picture called Screwballs, which Leonard Maltin had kind of review of, made by morons for morons. One of my best reviews ever. But Screwballs was a very big hit for Roger. It was one of those films where, again, Roger didn't want to make it. He made it in Canada and wasn't aware of what anybody was doing. And we just made it and played. We tested it in Westwood and went through the roof. And that was a huge hit and sold it to the Universe. So,
Kelly, I was wondering what your favorite memory of filming
And also while we have you here, I have such a cool credit, same question about Fast Times. Oh, what's my favorite moment? Gosh, they're all favorite moments. Favorite moment? Well, I just remember Fast Times at Ridgemont High, walking on that set, and I'd never been to California, and there I was on the Universal set, and this had been moving, and I had read the book, you know, and just gotten the script. And as I walked onto the set, all these people were there. The cruising vessel came up and hit its mark. And when the director yelled cut, I went, "The cruising vessel!" Just like some, you know, heck. And they all turned around and they went, "Someone has enthusiasm for this movie. I can't believe it," because everybody else had already been there for a while. And I just had this feeling, even though I had no reason to feel this way, that we were doing something really, really special. And I never lost that feeling. Also, you know, Sean Penn walking around as the caller for the entire shoot was great, too. One time he decided that he was getting too friendly with the rest of us and wanted us all to hate him. So he stuck out a cigarette in his hand. I thought, this guy is so committed because we were all kids and we were all into him at the walking. So I really thought that was the greatest thing ever. On Chopping Mall, it was so strange. I would lose my car every night. I would park, and then in the morning I couldn't remember where I parked because we were all so tired. And we would curl up like little hamsters in between takes, you know, like me and Tony O'Dell. So we all curled up. And I remember thinking, well, I bet we look like hamsters. And just because it was, Jim had
actors. The actors could sleep, but the crew and myself couldn't. We just had to keep going and going and going. So I don't know if you ever had a thing where you had to sleep days and work nights, but it turns your whole system inside.
We found out Wynorski was putting tinfoil on his windows. Everything in his apartment was tinfoil so that no light would get.
It's an old Elvis trick.
Well, I guess the first time I remember that. It was kind of creepy and yet cool at the same time. And also, you know, I really just like the running. I had just learned how to do this because on the Zero Boys, it was a steady cam following me, so I had to look like I was really booking, but I couldn't go very fast. The minute you go too fast, the cameraman hates you because you ruined the shot. So you have to look, but you have to go really, really slow. So I kind of, and I got yelled at so many times on the Zero Boys. I really felt I had this down, and I still, it was really a challenge. But that was fun.
She did a great job on the show. Give him a lot of rights, Bill.
Yeah.
Beforehand.
Yeah.
And then the show. So enjoy yourselves, guys.